Here we'll discuss partial molar properties. And essentially what these are is properties we assign to individual compounds or components in a mixture. Even though these are mixed on a molecular level, we can still try and assign properties. And the way we do that is by assigning partial molar properties. And the partial molar properties are such that if we have a binary system, and X1 is the mole fraction component 1, and let's look at partial molar volume, so the line over the top, this is the partial molar volume of component 1, and mole fraction component 2, the partial molar of component 2. So essentially, we sum up the partial molar properties times the mole fractions, we get the molar property. So this is the volume, and this is all molar quantities, so this is volume of the mixture per mole of mixture, and this is the partial molar volume for component 2. So V1 bar and V2 bar are functions of the composition of the mixture. In general, they're not equal to the molar volume of component 1 or the molar volumes of component 2. So we can envision if we had a system where the mole fraction of component 1 was 0.6 and component 2 was 0.4. So it's liquid phase and its total volume is 1 liter. We had a very small amount of component 1 and we observe that the volume increases by a small amount. The mole fractions change slightly, so I've indicated they're approximately equal to these values, but obviously they're slightly different. Well, the partial molar quantity is the change in the volume for a change in the number of moles of component 1, where we're keeping constant temperature, pressure, and number of moles of component 2. So notice in this problem, we've added component 1, the number of moles of component 2 is the same before and after. So in approximation, since we added a small amount, we could take the final volume minus the initial volume, that's in liters, and divide it by the number of moles of component 1 that we added. And this is going to be a reasonable approximation to the partial molar quantity for component 1. Right, so this is estimate of V1. Obviously, it gets better the smaller amount that we add. And as we change the composition of this liquid mixture, then this value for the partial molar quantity is going to change. So if our starting mole fraction is X1 equals 0.1, we get a quite different value. And then the same idea applies for partial molar enthalpies, internal energy, entropies, Gibbs free energy. They're all defined partial molar quantities as the change, in this case, of the enthalpy per mole, change in component 1, temperature, pressure. And if we're looking at a system with 5 components, then it'll be N2, N3, N4, N5 are kept constant while we vary the number of moles of N1. And then analogous for the other species. And again, the same idea, H, the enthalpy for the mixture per mole, is the sum of the mole fractions times the partial molar quantities of the species.